How can I help you?
I got off to a bad start with this card, and I want to try to rectify this and see if we could start out fresh.
Okay, so what are you saying now? You have started off at a bad start.
Yeah, we got off to a bad. Uh-huh. We got off to a bad. I got the card, and I didn't realize that I had to make a payment, so they never activated it.
Okay, it's $140 due to bring it up. Well, $192 actually.
$192
to bring it up today.
Well, I'm talking about just. I mean, if we could just get rid of that for now, you know, put that aside, and just start. If I could just start as if all these fees never happened, and just start all
okay.
over again.
No, you have to make that payment if that's the way you're going to start it. You have to meet the obligations. You just can't let the account go this far delinquent and say wipe everything off and let's start fresh. You have to bring the account current.
I mean, well, you gave me the car. I was in the same position back then as I am in now. I'm not working, and I'm desperate. And I need to get my hands on some cash here, and this is a way to do it. If you
okay.
could just turn the card off for me.
You can't get any cash off this account.
No, if you turn it on for me, I could. If you turn the thing on.
We can't turn this on, sir. It doesn't work like that. You've let the account, you had a payment due on this account, and you didn't pay for 6 months. We can't.
Yeah, but can't you just, if we just, like, obliterate all those. I mean,
no,
this
it's
still,
not that
but these
either.
Are all fees.
Okay, I realize that.
These are all fees you got here. I didn't buy a single thing.
Okay, now, once the account is closed, it's closed.
But you got, I mean, you still want me as a customer.
Okay.
Don't you want me to be, I mean, if you could start from, like,
well,
the fact that I never used the card, how did that affect anybody?
Okay, but you didn't meet your obligations. You're saying we want you as a customer. But you didn't show.
Meaning the obligation, that doesn't mean, you know, that's neither here nor there.
Okay.
I've disappointed everyone I've ever come in contact with. But I'm saying if we could.
We can't do that, sir. The account has been closed. No, we cannot do that. You have to reapply.
I mean, I'm just, you know, I got this brochure. I got the card.
Reapply, sir. We can't reopen this account.
But,
Unless you make the payments on the account, what is your reason for not paying?
I'm trying to get out of my situation. The brochure says, I aspire to financial flexibility.
You won't be able to do it this time. We won't be able to honor that. You're trying to get.
But I aspire to financial flexibility. That's right in the brochure.
Sir,
I aspire to prove myself and feel confident.
But wait,
let me read something out of the brochure.
Well, I already know what the
I feel confident about myself and splurge. Hello?
We will not open the.
It says splurge right in the thing.
What is it that you don't understand that I'm saying?
I'm telling you, in your brochure, it says for me to go out and splurge.
Okay, sir.
Do you know that?
Have a good day.
Hello?
Well, I'm going to start my show with something exciting, some mime. You like mime? All right. I'm not that good. I talk. I'm a talking mime. I'm in a box. I can't get out. I'm in a box. Oh, no. The box is getting really small.
You guys are great, man. My personal life is not going that well. It's not that well. It's my girlfriend. Yeah. Oh, man. She's not. She's very immature, my girlfriend. She's playing all these games with my head that make me really jealous. Like about a year ago, she got married and had this kid.
I went to the gym today. Do I look, thanks. Feel free to laugh at the jokes at your own pace over there if you want to. Feel free to laugh at my act individually if you want. I went to the gym today. Do I look pumped, huh? Do I? Yeah, I'm about to burst right here, folks. I don't know how to work out yet. I don't know how to talk to these big, thick, inflatable guys at the gym. With those big belts, they want to talk to me using gym slang. Hey, pal, hey, you, come here. You want to spot me? Yeah, what do you want, man? $5? $10? We're going to get this back. But of course, spotting the guy means that I stand over him to make sure that he doesn't drop the 400 pounds that I can't lift on his face. That's my job. And he's lying down there like, one, two. And he's spitting up my gym shorts at the... It feels pretty nice, actually, so. Yeah, I go to the gym like twice a day now. I don't work out, I just spot people. Girls work out like crazy now. Girls go to the gym for like 8 hours. They work out all day long. They get really skinny, and then they go home and they put shoulder pads in their clothes. And they check them. We got a little shoulder pad check going on over there. A little. You got to make sure they're in the right spot. You know, you're having dinner with your date. Everything about her appears to be okay. All of a sudden. Are you all right? Oh, uh-huh, yeah, I'm fine. Well, did Simon say to do that? Oh, no. Well, should I steal or should I hold?
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. And let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
I took a vacation and I did like a little show in this club during the vacation. The next day, I walked down the boardwalk and I got recognized from the show. It felt great. This girl saw me. She went, Mike Reynolds! How you doing? I'm Mike Reynolds. She went, Mike Reynolds! I'm right here. She goes, Mike Reynolds! I went up to her. She was saying bike rentals. You guys are great. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
You